I feel the need. The need for speed.
Good afternoon, YouTube. Welcome back to The Truth According to Lily. I am your host, Lily, and today I'm back on popular demand. I'm feeling much better, as you may have seen in my last video. If you watched it, I was at the beginning of feeling very under the weather. After I filmed that video that night, I had a massive headache that lasted about 24 hours. It was absolutely miserable, really horrible. You don't want to get this cold that's going around right now. And it wasn't fun. I'm feeling much better, as you can obviously see. However, I have taken some pain medication to deal with the fact that I had some fillings put in this morning. You might still be able to see the swelling. Probably not, it's probably gone down since this morning. But I had some fillings put in and I had some Novocaine. My tongue was numb for a while, that wasn't cool. But I'd rather be numb. But I've taken some ibuprofen to just so I can talk about these two movies that I watched back to back. And I mean that sincerely. I watched these movies back to back and I just gotta talk about it before my ibuprofen wears off. In the span of a few hours, I watched Top Gun, that came out in 1986, starring Tom Cruise, directed by, Ridley Scott. No. Directed by Tony Scott. And then following that, I decided to watch Days of Thunder, which came out 4 years later in 1990. I remember watching Days of Thunder more growing up than Top Gun. I'm pretty sure I ended up watching Top Gun like as a young adult on my own. But really, they're basically the same movie with minor details changed, but they're basically the same movie. It's one of the first things I noticed about Top Gun when I was watching it, because I now watch Top Gun at least once a year. I love Top Gun. I know it's just a recruitment movie. I know it's basically propaganda. I honestly don't give a shit. I don't care. And yes, I'm aware of what a monster Tom Cruise is. Which I still don't understand why everyone's so mad at Chris Pratt for being just like a Christian good old boy, but nobody is gonna say anything about Tom Cruise and how he should be removed from movies. Just saying. And here's the thing, I can't decide which movie has more of the cheese.
Step is to fold in the cheese.
What does that mean? What does fold in the cheese mean?
You know that late 80s, early 90s cheese factor. Which one of these movies came off the assembly line just coated in glorious 80s, 90s cheese? And I guess it might end up depending on like, which do you prefer more? Do you prefer the 80s, you know, cheese? I mean like yacht music, Miami Vice cheese, or do you prefer the more, I don't even know how to describe Top Gun's cheese. It's just, I've said cheese so many times also, now I just really want cheese. I fucking love cheese. And then so a nice smoked Gouda would be really, over toast would be really good right about now, when it's slightly melted.
And then periodically returning to the end, maybe giving different characters perspectives throughout, just to, you know, give it a bit of dynamism. Otherwise it's just sort of a linear story.
Just tell us what happened.
It has those like strings, ugh. Fucking love cheese. And I guess it all depends on what kind of cheese you're craving. I gotta stop with this cheese analogy. I've already lost you probably at minute 30. You know, as much love as I have for Top Gun, I mean the volleyball scene, people of Earth, the volleyball scene has no context whatsoever. If you're watching Top Gun, if you haven't seen it in a while, but the volleyball scene is like burned in your brain, as it should be, because I mean, move over Tom Cruise. I'm talking about Val Kilmer right now. 1 minute, Maverick is in a classroom hitting on Kelly McGillis, who is his instructor, by the way. And I think she's supposed to be older than him, but I don't actually know what the age difference between Tom Cruise and Kelly McGillis actually is. But I think she's supposed to be older than him. But anyway, 1 minute he's in a classroom hitting on Kelly McGillis, and then literally the next scene, those motherfuckers are half naked playing volleyball on a beach. There's no context for it whatsoever. And I guess someone could say, well, Lily, the context is that they're competitive bros who want to get half naked and jump around on a beach and play volleyball, which is like totally fine. Like, I'm fine. Thank you, Tony Scott, for giving that to us. I'm fine with it. I think I like the cast of Top Gun more. Let's see, I got the cast list over now. You know, you have the young Tim Robbins in this, by the way, playing Merlin. Val Kilmer, Kelly McGillis, Tom Cruise, Anthony Edwards, Tom Skerritt, Michael Ironside. makes every movie he's in significantly better. You got baby Meg Ryan in this movie, which is funny that Meg Ryan ended up marrying Dennis Quaid and Randy Quaid is actually in Days of Thunder. I just think that's a funny little connection between the movies. Baby Adrian Pasdar of Heroes fame. Like, this movie was like the jumping off point for like quite a few actors, which I think is just awesome. And James Tolkien of Back to the Future fame. I mean, I don't know if he was in Back to the Future yet at this point, but he's the guy who always yelled, "Slacker!" Fucking love that guy. I love the principle of Back to the Future, honestly. Because as I get older, I feel more and more like him. Then on the flip side, you have Days of Thunder's cast, which again has Tom Cruise, baby Nicole Kidman, Robert Duvall, Randy Quaid, Cary Elwes is in this movie, Fred Thompson, John C. Reilly, a wonderful, actually very understated performance by Michael Rooker. I've always really liked Michael Rooker, and he's super hot in Days of Thunder. Like, I was not expecting Michael Rooker to be hot in Days of Thunder. I was like, wait, what? Well, what'd you say? And Days of Thunder might have the best line ever said by Randy Quaid, which is,
"And what do? We end up looking like a monkey fucking a football out there."
Which I'm just like, who did Randy Quaid just think of that? I need to know if that was scripted or if he just thought of that. I need answers because I have questions. To quote Emily Baker, I have questions. Move to strike. That should also tell you where my mind's been at lately. I believe Tom Cruise also had a, looks like Tom Cruise has a writing credit for Days of Thunder as well, which doesn't surprise me. He's 4 years since Top Gun. And now he's giving a writer's credit for Days of Thunder, which is a very similar movie. However, I will say his character in Days of Thunder, Cole Trickle, which is just such a NASCAR driver's name. His character in Days of Thunder, I will say, I think at least is a little more humble. And I really enjoy the scene when he finally admits to Robert Duvall's character. He's like, "I don't know the terminology. I have no idea what you're saying." Coming off of watching Formula One racing, which I really, really enjoy, I can pretty much never watch it because it's usually in a completely different country with a completely different time zone. And I have work in the morning, so I can enjoy the one sport that I enjoy. Coming off of watching, you know, racing shows like Formula One, you know, it is very different. It all means the same thing, but they all say it differently. And except for like, you know, pitting or a pit crew or, you know, little things like that. So I do really like the scene when he finally admits to Robert Duvall, "Hey, I have no idea what you're talking about. I can't take your cues or your advice because I don't know what it means." And he's not driving a stock car. You wouldn't drive a stock car the same way you would drive a Formula One car. They're completely different cars for completely different types of racing. I think the editing in Days of Thunder is so freaking good. It's really, really good. It's very harrowing. They're able to capture, and in my opinion, and I know the movie is actually not entirely accurate when it comes to NASCAR racing. I actually read quite a bit about that. But they managed to capture just the, if you've ever watched racing of any kind, you know that there is a suspenseful atmosphere that just encompasses every aspect of it. And I think they managed to capture that really well. Every time I watch Top Gun, I appreciate more of what Tony Scott was trying to do and what he ended up doing for action films. There's not a lot of people who die in it. In fact, I think, you know, despite the bad guys, whoever they're supposed to be, North Korean or Russian, whatever. I think I read somewhere that they were supposed to be North Korean, but I can't be 100% certain on that. So what he did for action movies, there's very few deaths in it besides the 3-4 bad guys at the end. The only character that we really care about who dies is Goose. And that scene is still really sad to me. It still chokes me up a little bit because like, oh no, I like Goose. He's a nice guy. I think I read somewhere that production of Top Gun had to pay the Pentagon like $1.5 million to use their planes. And it's just like, and honestly, the technique, the ability to fly these kinds of aircraft, the mental capacity that you have to be this type of pilot. Obviously, the movie is very fictionalized. They embezzle quite a few things, but it should make you appreciate these people, especially when you're watching the stunts being performed in the film. It truly is mind-boggling every time I watch it that they were able to accomplish this much and that there's people who can actually do those things. And that unfortunately during the filming of Top Gun, a stunt pilot was unfortunately killed, and I don't think his plane or his body was ever recovered. He went into what Maverick and Goose's characters go into, which is, I believe, is called a flat spin, and he wasn't able to recover from it, and that's really, really sad. And it just shows to show you just how dangerous their job really is. I mean, these guys go on to sometimes be astronauts. But as far now, just getting back to, you know, backpedal a little bit, backspace that shit, the cheese factor. I cannot, even now filming this, cannot decide which movie has the more cheese. I'm going to leave it up to you guys to decide. I love both movies. I thoroughly enjoyed watching these movies back to back. It was so much fun. They're cheesy, they're overdramatic, overacted at times, but they are what they are. And Top Gun and Days of Thunder do not lie about what they are. And that is why I enjoy them, in spite of the fact that, you know, Top Gun is basically a recruitment film. Days of Thunder is just, it is what it is. It's a NASCAR racing movie. That's what it is. Yeah, it's not entirely accurate, but it's also, I don't really think it lies either. Embezzled to an extent, and I think that they just wanted to make it as fun as possible. And at the end of the day, I feel like racing should be fun. I think you should go out there and have fun, and you should be competitive, because that's, you know, it's a competitive fucking sport. So that's why I enjoy both of these movies, because they are what they are and they don't lie about it. They make no bones about it. Honestly, sometimes I just need that in a cheesy film. Sometimes that's why I watch cheesy films sometimes. You know, Overboard is about a man who tricks a woman with amnesia into being his wife because she was rude to him. That movie doesn't lie. That movie is absolutely out and proud about what it is. Kurt Russell is tricking Goldie Hawn into being his wife while she has amnesia. He gets her to have sex with him. He gets her to raise his children to the point where his children choose her over him. And they're in on it. They're in on the lie. The whole town's in on the lie. But that movie doesn't lie about what it is. It doesn't try to tell you that this is something else. Oh no, they actually had a romantic connection when they first met. No, there was absolutely no romantic connection whatsoever. Absolutely none. But does it lie to you? Does Overboard lie to you? It absolutely does not. It is not trying to be something it isn't. So with that being said, movies from the 80s were far more honest. They were still bad sometimes, though. So yeah, this has just been my quick little movie recommendation. Watch Top Gun, watch Days of Thunder. They're fun, they're ridiculous. It makes you want to get into an F-14, F-16, whatever the fuck they're flying. Makes you want to get in there, pull some G's. And honestly, I don't watch Top Gun for Tom Cruise. Iceman's where it's at, baby. I'm telling you, Iceman's where it's at. It is. Oh, if you have a chance, please watch Val Kilmer's documentary on Amazon Prime, I believe. Absolutely fantastic documentary. Absolutely fantastic. Thank you for watching. Live long and prosper. Peace and long life. And I feel the need. The need for speed.